happy to send you under separate cover 5 gross of Stan Stench. Tan trench coats for use in your...
Here is Stan Stench, founder, president, and guiding spirit of the Stan Stench Tan Trenchcoat Company. Stan has learned the tan trenchcoat business well and has managed to monopolize the field, chiefly by use of a workforce of highly trained squirrels and an advertising campaign built around catchy slogans such as, wherever you go, people will notice your stench. He is, in fact, this nation's only manufacturer of tan trench coats. Now he's on his way home to his loving wife, Exie. Stan Stench is in for a surprise.
I guess I'll make myself a sandwich. I've never been one before. Oh, breaks me up. Oh, gee, that's a little heart attack. Oh, yeah, that's what it looks like. Lots of good goodies in here. What a joker. Murdered. Come to think of it, she did sort of have a frigid air about her lately. Well, this is no job for the local police. I'd better call the FBI.
That was Stan's Stench. Stan Stench Tan Trenchcoat Company. His wife's just been murdered in a grisly way.
Mauled by a bear?
No, she was found frozen to death in the family icebox.
Killed in cold blood, huh?
No. As you know, this crime has international implications. Looks like a job. For you know who. Fortunately, he's in California making a movie. So I guess we'll have to turn the case over to Good Friday. Right now, he's on a high priority morals case somewhere near the White House.
Thank you. Yes, yes, this is Super Secret Agent Good Friday. Yeah, boss. All right. Okay, I'll be right over.
What?
Good Friday. I suppose you realize that our nation's security depends on this man, Stench. The principal instrument of America's foreign policy resides in that great body known as the Central Intelligence Agency, better known as the CIA. The CIA uses tan trench coats by the thousands, and without them, all operations would grind to a halt. The sole supplier of these trench coats is Stan Stench and the Stan Stench Tan Trench Coat Company. It is imperative that we prevent further intimidation of Mr. Stench by finding the evil fiends who murdered his wife. We're not sure, but we suspect the murderers to be agents of a large Euro-Asian country, the name of which can't be revealed for security reasons. I'm detailing you to track down this menace to our nation. Now, Good Friday. Good luck to ya.
Yeah.
Yeah, what do you want?
Mr. Stench, I'm from the FBI.
Sorry, I bought two for my daughter last week. I'm not interested.
You don't understand. This concerns your wife.
Nothing concerns my wife since last night. She'll just give you the cold shoulder. But come in anyhow. Fix yourself a sandwich.
Thanks. Don't mind if I do.
Let's see here. Grapefruit, duck fat with pineapple, mustard, turnip greens.
Mr. Stench, whom do you think murdered your wife?
Frankly, I think it was agents of some large Euro-Asian country, the name of which I can't reveal for security reasons.
I better look for some clues.
I think I'll ask Jed to transfer me back to the Vice Squad. Chasing clamp thieves. Guess I better lift that print, take it back to the lab for analysis.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Good.
Good who? Good grief? Good night? Good golly, Miss Molly?
No, it's Good Friday.
Good heavens, well, come in.
Hi, J-Ed.
Yeah, what do you want? I'm busy.
I found this on the Stench case. What do you think?
Make no mistake about it, Good Friday. That's thumbprint. For days, Inspector Good Friday of the FBI searched high and low for thumbs. Thumbs that would match the description of the one he had so fortunately found in the Stench home. He found fat thumbs, short thumbs, tall thumbs, thin thumbs, long thumbs, plum thumbs, some thumbs, and gum thumbs. Good Friday remembers well the last words of J. Edgar Electrolux.
Remember to find the man with the distinctive thumbprint. See if you can't give it a whirl.
And then Lady Luck caused her countenance to shine on our boy, Friday. Hey, you, come on out of there.
Yeah,
on Good Friday. FBI. Like to ask you a few questions. First of all, have you always been a professional ping pong paddle?
No, I was in the minor leagues once, and before that, I served pizzas. But I got tired of cleaning anchovies from underneath my thumbnail.
Well, Mr., what did you say your name was?
My friends call me the Hitchhiker.
Well, Mr. Hiker, we're looking for a man with a very distinctive thumb. So if you could thumb it up the will to let me look at your thumb. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Hiker, but your thumb does not meet government specifications.
Well, that's too bad. But perhaps you'd care to join me in a game of ping pong.
Sorry, I didn't bring my trunks. But mark my words, that's thumb thumb. I have a hunch. When I was at the home of Stan Stench, I remember noticing he had saliva on his hat, excessively greasy hair, and a habit of keeping his hand in his pocket. I remember thinking at the time how unusual it was for a man to have a frying pan in his pants. I guess we better haul him in. I hate to grill you like this, Stench, but I'm only making myself a sandwich. You've never been one before.
Yes, I was. 17 themes ago.
Isn't it true, Mr. Stench, that in the morning you habitually put the butter from breakfast in the icebox, put on your hat, kiss your wife, and leave?
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Is it possible that on the particular morning that your wife was discovered murdered, that you mistakenly kissed your hat, put the butter on your head, put your wife in the icebox?
butter.
Well, Mr. Stench, your death won't be quick, but at least it will be excruciating.